Welcome to Evening Prayers for Sunday the 11th of September. Our theme for this evening is responding in worship. So this evening's prayers contain the last part of the story that we began on Thursday, we continued yesterday, and it finishes today. On Thursday, we looked at the story in Genesis of how the world, so early on after its creation, had distanced itself so far from God that the people of the world no longer knew God, could no longer see God or hear God, and as a result, it was impossible for them to receive God's love and God's salvation. There was only one person in the entire world that had kept that connection with God, and that was a man called Noah. And as the one faithful person, God protects him in an ark at the time of a great flood which flooded the world. And Noah and his family and the animals, the created order brought together into that ark, became a place of safety, a symbol of hope for the earth. It became a place of the seeds of a new relationship with God, a new life, a new world, a new way of being, and it set the path moving all the way through the next part of the Bible to the point where we get to meet God in Jesus, God among us, and the relationship which was so broken is restored. Well, today's reading shows Noah's response to the fact that God remembered them and God protected them and God gave them hope for the future. He recognises God in all that has happened to him. And Noah's first response is to worship, connecting himself and his family and the world with God again and communicating with God and hearing God. So let's hear this part of the story from Genesis chapter 8, verses 20 to 22.
Then Noah built an altar to the Lord, and taking some of all the clean animals and clean birds, he sacrificed burnt offerings on it. The Lord smelled the pleasing aroma and said in his heart, "Never again will I curse the ground because of humans, even though every inclination of the human heart is evil from childhood. And never again will I destroy all living creatures as I have done. As long as the earth endures, seed time and harvest, cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night, will never cease."
The way Noah worships is to build an altar and offer a sacrifice on it, which was the tradition of the time. Over the centuries, our understanding and our methods of worship and the ways we connect with God have changed. And now our altars become the centre point of our worship as we gather in churches, or a table in the centre of our community, or a Bible study, or a house group, as we gather often with a cross or a candle, a Bible or a symbol of God on it. At those places, at those altars, we experience God. We experience God's love and the sacrifice that is made on those altars is not the sacrifice of animals, which is in the time of Noah, but is the sacrifice of Holy Communion, a time of wholeness, when we are at one with each other and with God. And so our prayers this evening bring us back to worship. They reflect how we respond to God in worship. Let us pray. Come and worship, you who would love God with all your soul. Come and serve, you who would love God with all your strength. Come and find peace, you who would love God with all your mind. In Jesus' name, come. Amen. And our next prayer is the song, Here I Am to Worship. Lord, as we worship, make our worship yours. As we praise your name, hallow our praise. As we adore you, breathe on our adoration and draw our hearts towards you, that our feet may follow, dancing. Amen. Gracious God, in coming to worship, we know that you welcome us. Yet we come to you uncertain of our identity as your people, but sure of our sins. God, forgive us and remember our sins no more. We come to you unworthy of the grace we have received in your Son, Jesus Christ. God, forgive us and remember our sins no more. We come to you unreliably as we fail in our promises to listen to or faithfully follow your call. Oh God, forgive us and remember our sins no more. We come to you ungrateful for the gifts of love, forgiveness and life we have received time and time again without measure. Oh God, forgive us and remember our sins no more. Thanks be to you, for you are our God, the Lord, the giver of life, calling us as one people under one baptism into one faith, who offers merciful forgiveness and restores us into life-giving relationships with you, all creation, and one another. Amen. We come to worship God, who has taken away our dirty garments and replaced them with spotless robes. We come to worship God, who has set us free from our pasts and given us a living hope for the future. We come to worship God, who has demolished the barriers between us and calls us all children and heirs. Thank you, Father, for the amazing work that Christ has done for us and for your Spirit who has given us your life. Amen. To a sacred world of worship, we bring our secular selves with all the burdens of the people we know and love, all the burdens of the people we hear of and see, all the burdens of the people we laugh and cry with. All-powerful God, who understands our needs before we think and speak, we unload our pains and our joys, our sorrows and our celebrations, and bring our prayers before you. For the hurting and the hurt, for the loved and the loveless, for the young and the old, for believers and non-believers, for those certain of their faith and those who waver, for those of different faiths and identities from us, for the ill, and for those in pain and distress, for the dying and those whose bodies are etched with the marks of death and dying, for the grieving whose minds are bewildered and burdened by grief. All-powerful God, surround each and every one with the circle of your protection. Amen. And tonight, a sending prayer is a blessing for each one of us. A blessing on us for our faithfulness in worship. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, three in one and one in three. A blessing on our relationships and those who need us the most. In the name of God, Creator, Redeemer, and Saviour, three in one and one in three. And a blessing on our lives as we go about our daily business. In the name of God, who was and is to come, 3 in 1 and 1 in 3. Amen.